Hello and welcome to the Repair series. In this video, which is part 2, if you haven't seen the first part, have a look here at the link. We are going to finish the repair of the broken neck. I still have to do several things, like make an extra piece of wood which is going into the block, glue the neck on its place, and the back, and also the nut. First of all, I will finish the inner part of the block, which is still too big. The neck goes into the body and it's glued primarily on four surfaces. The two outer parts, here and here, go in this side and in this side. The back of the neck, this side, goes here, and this is a very big surface. And the under part that goes to the nut. Although this surface is the biggest, it doesn't glue. The problem is that this part of the neck is this part, and this is a bit like a bunch of straws altogether, because all the juices of the tree go from the roots to the leaves through all these tiny little tubes. That would look a bit like this. All my straws together. So when you put glue here, all the glue goes into these small tubes, and there doesn't remain anything on the surface. So when you put glue on this surface, all the glue goes into the wood and it doesn't glue. That's why we lose all this surface. There remains this one and this one, which are very small, and the nut. So the nut is very important. In this instrument, the nut has broken off the back. This is the back, and as you see, there is no nut anymore. The nut is here. It should go like that. Now, because this has broken and I cannot glue it anymore back to its place, exactly because of the same reason I just explained, I am going to double, as we say, the nut by putting an extra piece of wood into the block. This piece will go in the corner block between the back and the neck. Here I'm cutting the block to create the space needed. The gap in the block is ready. Now I will use a piece of maple to make the new part. This part will be the new joint between the block and the neck, instead of the back through the nut. First, I marked the wood so I knew where to cut, and then, using the files, I gave it the exact shape. As you see now, it's a tight fit. Now that the extra piece is ready, I can mark how much I have to take off the neck, and then I can glue it on its place. This little part can go away. That's it. As it is a very tight fit, I don't need to put a clamp on it. The neck is glued now on its place. Now I have to make one nice neat surface between the neck and the block, so I can glue the extra piece on its place. Now that this part fits properly, I will cut all the excess wood off, so I don't have to do it after. Now it's much easier because I can draw a line and take it off and work on it. And otherwise, if I do it after, I will have the neck and the body in my way and it's not so easy. Now that the extra piece is ready and nicely trimmed, I will glue it on its place and I put a clamp also on it. Taking the clamp off, I'm almost done with this repair. Now I have to clean the surface and make it flat following the block, and then I can put the bug on its place. And finally, I can glue this little piece here on its proper place. As you see, the instrument is ready. I put the pegs on, I made a new bridge, strings and tailpiece on their place. This is how it looks, much better than at the beginning of this whole journey, you could say. Thank you very much for watching. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it. Subscribe so you can see the following videos. Have a look to the violin making series, and I will see you next time. Bye bye!